comparison to other organisms. And for that, if we go back to the classification which was given by Whittaker in 1969, where he tried to divide every living organism into the five kingdoms, he couldn't give any place to the viruses in any of the kingdoms. You all must be knowing we call them subcellular. Now the reason being calling them subcellular is that if you look into the modern theory of Schleiden, Chuan and Virchow, what exactly is a cell which has both the set of nucleic acids? Viruses do not obey that. They have either DNA or RNA. That is the reason they are subcellular. In addition to that, we all know they have no metabolic machinery of their own. They do reproduce, which is a feature, a remarkable feature of the living organism. But for reproduction, viruses do require another organism. And what is really exceptional about them, on the basis of genetics, they do not obey the central dogma of molecular biology. So if we say that they have one set of the nucleic acid, that is, if we try to look at the diversity of viruses on basis of the nucleic acid, first of all, we will call them eukaryotes. No question of here nucleus. But on the basis of nucleic acid, they are deoxyvira, having set of DNA, or they are reovira, having set of RNA, or something very unique called as retrovira,